Okay, so this is the KWL Plus chart demo part two. And in this demo, I'm going to demonstrate some steps of the reading process, including how to use pre-reading and predicting to complete the what you know phase of the KWL Plus process, as well as how to use the prediction and skimming and scanning to set questions for reading to prepare you to read more effectively. Also, we're going to take a look at how to use the KWL Plus chart. I'm going to demonstrate that for you using an article in the chart itself. And then finally, I'll make some brief comments on how to use the KWL Plus chart to draw conclusions and make generalizations. Okay, so let's take a look at the article we've chosen for this. This again is an kind of article that I would give a student who's doing research on how to get into college. And you can find this video at mrbrayman.info, and you can follow the link at the bottom of the screen here and see the article for yourself. And I do recommend that you read it before you watch the rest of this video, just so you can get a sense of where I'm going with this and why I'm doing what I'm doing. Okay, so we're going to pretend that we're doing this reading as a part of a research project on college readiness, right? How to get into college, how to find funding, how to pay for college, how to choose a college. So that let's, say this is part of a larger research project. So as a student, I've chosen this article because it obviously has a very catchy title, right? College Scholarship Money. So already I'm making predictions about what I'm going to learn here. And the site you see the subtitle, Advice on How to Get a College Scholarship. So as always, I'm going to skim and scan and make predictions. So quickly, it looks like, they're talking about the difficulties of paying for college, different options, how to choose the options well, and finally, it looks like some advice and how to avoid being scammed. Okay. Now this article is very nice because it has some section headings, and so these are probably going to become some pre-reading questions that I establish. So it's telling me about researching the college readiness process and how to apply for certain forms or certain forms of scholarship. Also, it looks like it gives me kind of timeline of when these kind of things are going to happen, what months, what part of the senior year these will happen. Got another section heading here. It's going to make a difference between two kinds of scholarship money. It's good to understand. Yes, and don't get scammed, right? How to protect yourself. Okay, so I have a pretty clear, well-organized, looks like I got a bulleted list here with some key topics. And then that's it. So it looks like a really well-organized article here with some really clear main ideas. And so after looking over this, I already know some things, right? So I'm going to do this on the source entitled College Scholarship. And it's the title of an article, so I'm going to put it in quotation marks. And always I want to put things in my own words, especially in the L column, right? I want to show that I actually understand things, and I actually want to understand things by putting things into my own words. So I already know some things about college, right? College is expensive, it costs money, scholarships are money given, that's a key word, right? Given to students to help pay. Right? And for my pre-reading, I know that I should plan, that I should, let's see, what was that other section heading? The different kinds, right? That there are different kinds of scholarships. And finally, of that I should avoid scams. So, I already know some things. I already have some of the main ideas in my head, right? Also, I should think of what my purpose is. My purpose is to learn. My purpose is to learn how to get scholarship dollars. Okay. And so I want to take some of these things and turn them into my, pre-reading questions, some things that I want to learn. Right. So I want to know what are the different kinds of scholarships? Right. I mean, I know a lot about athletic scholarships. We hear a lot about that on TV, but what else is there? Right. I want to know how do people get scammed? How do I avoid this? Right. And more than anything, of course, how can I get free money for school? I mean, that's, obviously my big, research project and what I'm doing here. Okay. So now I'm going to start to read, and as I read, I'm going to pull out facts. I could use quotes. Or I could put things into my own words, that I would rather you and I would rather see students put things into their own words to paraphrase those concrete details, those facts, because it shows what students know more effectively. Also, I want to put citations in, right? Maybe paragraph number, a double P means paragraph, or page number. And that's going to make it easier when I go back to do my citations in my research paper. So this is just a little thing. You don't have to do it. Doesn't necessarily aid in comprehension, but it's going to make your research process much more effective and streamlined and allow you to produce better work more quickly. Okay? So I'm going to go through this now and I'm just going to read very quickly. So start search early. That's the most important thing. Start search early. Need is also growing. So even in sophomore year. Okay, so these are all the things that I should send in to get college scholarships, applications, recommendations, essays, test scores, transcripts. And of course, we do still need to save money. Okay, looks like junior year. I should be going to financial aid information seminars. Very often, those are held at your high school or sometimes at public libraries in your neighborhood. All right, some key dates here. So, I'm going to start in November. To do the federal free application for federal student aid. Okay, looks like parents or guardians have to help. Okay, this looks like student aid report in March. See, I'm going to kind of construct a timeline here of all the things I could do to make sure that the FAFSA is accurate. Okay. It's like in April, I'm going to get some financial award letters. Okay. You have to pick. This is key to loans versus grants or scholarships. Loans are nice, but I would much rather have free money. Okay, looks like I'm supposed to sign the award letter in May and make a choice. They also want you to decline. That's kind of nice. Decline any other award letters, right? Release that money for someone else. Okay, it's a good timeline. So the difference between need and merit-based. Need-based is awarded to students who come from lower income families. Merit-based is kind of sometimes what we think of as normal scholarships. Okay, so see how I use my pre-reading questions here to help me set some purpose. And by asking those questions, that alerted me to important information. I was more, more open to the important ideas based on my skimming, scanning, and predicting. Ah, so this is really good. Common misconceptions, right? That college scholarship money covers everything. Right? It's like, sometimes you can get smaller awards, they add up. Okay. So scams, right? The different scams. Yeah, so no, these are all the things that I shouldn't do, right? No processing fees, right? No guarantee. There are no guarantees. How could I get money if I don't enter? Right? Any free seminars? Okay. Okay. Good. Remember, scholarships are gifts. You should never have to pay a fee to receive one. Good. You've already read this, so I'm going quickly. Keep the video moving along. All right. Okay, great. So, I've now actively read and I've highlighted, underlined, circled, whatever you want to do, whatever you want to call it. I've marked out important ideas. And so I'm going to again put these in here, some of the main ideas. Start early. Okay. Need to do the federal application, so-called FAFSA. Again, I'm not going to write everything in here, but I'm going to go through and pick out the details that I think are the most important. Need to get parent guardian help. Make sure my info is accurate. Right, this one was really important. Need versus merit. Based equals from a poor family. Merit based equals ability. Smaller scholarships. And finally, scams, such as, I'm going to put a sublist here, fees, guarantees. Okay, so now I've identified some of the main ideas, and again, I did a skim and scan and set my purpose, and then that suggested some questions, and then these questions, are somewhat answered, but not completely, based on, the main ideas from my reading. So now I want to make connections here, right? And again, these can be inferences about why something is important. Causes and effects, comparison, contrast, text to self connections, text to world connections. Right, so start early. That's because this is a long process and has a lot of parts and steps. FAFSA, I know that the government has lots of money. Well, not really, but they have a lot of money. All right. Parent guardian help. That might be something I could ask a question about. I can also ask questions in here. Right? Why? Do they need parents' financial info? Make sure info is accurate. Okay. That could cost me money. Right? If they think I have more money than I do. Okay. Oh, yeah. So here's why. There's the connection there, right? Parents' financial info, to see if I qualify for merit or for need-based. Merit-based based on ability. So that's sports. Do I need something from my coach? Smaller scholarships, right? Those can certainly add up. And scams, that is, they must prey on people's hopes. Okay, so what did I do here? I came up with some cause and effect. I related to things I already know. I gave my own opinion. I made inferences about why things are important. Made a text to world connection, text to self connection. And so those are all the things that I can do with the plus column here. Okay, and so that's the use of the KWL plus chart. Now, as you saw in the first KWL plus video, I'm going to think about how we can make a generalization here. What's the generalization that I can make about this? Okay. And that's going to be based on facts. And then my conclusion is going to be kind of based on opinions and facts. Right? So the conclusion I can draw here based on all of this. So the conclusion I can draw is that getting a scholarship requires a lot of time and effort. That's kind of hard to read there, but that's the conclusion that I made based on everything in the plus column. Okay, and then of course I would need to be able to support that with facts from the L column, which I can clearly do, right? That I need to start early. That I need a lot of help from my parents. Those are things that take a long time, that it requires a lot of effort because I have to fill out a lot of applications and pay attention to a lot of scam, pay attention to make sure I don't get scammed and that I chase lots of different smaller scholarships. So those are all facts I can use to support this conclusion. Sorry. Okay, so that's it. That's using the KWL plus chart as well as some pre-reading strategies. Thanks, and for more information, check out mrbrayman.info/guest.